Good morning, Monday morning, back from Portugal, heading now to Tel Aviv for a day of back-to-back meetings, morning, tonight. Starting it bright and early with Lirone Glikman, who's become a force to be reckoned with in the video landscape recently. After that, meeting a woman named Rivka, who, let's just say I met her on LinkedIn with a less pleasant exchange, and then I randomly bumped into her when I was at Comatech, ampersand, the ultra-orthodox co-working space in Bnei Brak, so I'm catching up with her. Then lunch with the Stripe team, followed by a couple of meetings, and then tonight, heading to Jerusalem for a meeting with Turo, the US-based college, and then a call with the discount bank team in New York to talk about a possible collab. So it's going to be an insane day. Here we go. Day miracle, and now I'm putting away this camera and switching to this, the DJI Osmo Pocket, a device I have recently fallen in love with. Look at the B-roll. Bright and early with the one, the only, Lirone Glikman. By the way, I was thinking about it. You could not possibly have a more Jewish name. Lirone Glikman. How you doing? So happy we finally get to meet.
Certainly. Good. Good to see you this morning. Mm-hmm. You know, just starting the day. We need our coffee and then everything's going to be fine.
There you go. Baby, please have a little patience with me. Funny story. Like 2 months ago, 3 months ago? Less than 3 months ago, this nice woman tagged me on LinkedIn, right? With a few other people, and I may or may not have kind of yelled at her. Not really yelled, any yell, but virtually yelled and
you
said,
did.
Okay. Well, I said, what are you tagging all these people for? Anyway, we met like a month later in the ultra orthodox co-working space in Bnei Brak, and you came over and you're like, you yelled at me. Anyway, now we had lunch. What's your name? I mean, we had coffee. Rivka Zafrir. And yes. What does Rivka Zafrir do?
Currently, I'm doing a LinkedIn consultant for startups.
Very cool. And where did you grow up?
In Bnei Brak.
So you're like hardcore, as you call yourself, ultra-orthodox.
Yes, of course I do.
And yet you're sitting with me and we're doing a video blog. So I don't know. Tusk, tusk. But anyway, bottom
it's
line
an
is...
an interview. Yeah, it's okay. A professional.
Professional interview. Yeah. But listen, you know, I asked you like 10 times in the meeting how I can help. We haven't figured it out. But we'll have another cup of coffee and you'll figure out how I can help
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I want to keep the option open.
Sounds
to
good.
To another meeting.
Done.
Yeah.
Rivka Zafrir on LinkedIn. Yeah. So R-I-V-K-A. Zafrir on LinkedIn. People add you. Maybe if you need some help with LinkedIn, hit her up. Cool?
Thank you.
There you go. Thanks. Heading now to Mitos Street Food on Rothschild, meeting Stripe, Jackie from Stripe. I left my GH5, my monstrosity of a camera, in the car. I guess this is a good test to see how this DJI Osmo Pocket deals with wind. It's just too hot to carry on that big camera, so I'm using this thing instead. It is always a pleasure to catch up with old school, like what, high school?
I don't even high school.
We go to high school together?
Not the same grade.
But you were in Korea?
Yeah.
Okay, so we know each other basically from high school. Then let me just make sure. Okay, we're good. From high school, and now he's whooping some serious tuchus in the cyber world. Who are you? What's your name?
Yair Solow, CEO, co-founder of CyGov.
CyGov.co. CYGOV.co. Is there a story there why you're not .com, or should I not go there?
I'll go there.
Okay, we won't go there. All right, so like I said, high school. What have you done, by the way, before CyGov? When did you found the company?
2016.
So what were you doing? Give me the catch me up in 20 years. What did you do before that?
I was a senior executive at Visa. I headed a bunch of their business units in marketing and communications out in Europe.
Cool.
And helped the local team here launch the Innovation Hub out in Tel Aviv.
Sweet.
Got to see a lot of cyber companies. And then I identified a pain point opportunity and jumped in.
Beautiful. All right. Can you explain to me, if I was your grandmother, what is SciGov? Like, I know nothing about tech, I know nothing about cyber. What is SciGov?
So SciGov looks at a pain point in the market that addresses cyber risk management. So today companies are using spreadsheets.
You lost me already. Cyber risk management? Come on.
One second.
Dumb it down.
Okay, so companies today are trying to manage their cyber risks.
Got it.
By using spreadsheets and people to quantify those risks and then figure out what's more important and less important. The problem is
that
it's a very complicated problem,
right,
and you're using a very primitive solution to solve it today. So it's not working.
Okay, so hold on. Let me now dissect that a little bit. You said a couple of different things. Number one, every organization has serious vulnerabilities on the cyber side. We're all using computers, we're all using bring your own, you know, device, all our phones connected to the network, etc., etc. Every time you connect to Wi-Fi in a certain place, that is a vulnerability. Whether that vulnerability can create, you know, real problems or not is a different discussion, but that is a potential vulnerability. Every organization has cyber vulnerabilities. Now, the way you're telling me an organization today, and let's put aside for one second, you know, a restaurant. Let's talk about relatively innovative, the way they're managing or let's call it monitoring all those holes is using Excel.
So if you if we simplify it, think about like most companies are focused on finding the bad guys in the building,
right,
or trying to figure out how they got in. And what we're focused on is that preemptive stage of assessing whether your risks are properly managed. So are your doors protected well? Are your alarms protected well?
Right.
Defined well? Are there bars that you need on your windows, etc.?
So you're telling me,
that part is managed with spreadsheets.
I'm trying to understand this as a newbie, right? I'm not a cyber guy. You're telling me that the massive multi-trillion dollar cyber industry, the majority of the players in that industry are focused on, once the robber is in your house, how to locate that robber and get rid of it?
Yeah.
And you're focused on how to prevent them from coming in?
To begin with, yeah.
I mean, that sounds like a complete no-brainer. Like, why is no one else doing this?
No, so there are other companies doing it that we're connecting a lot of pieces that are done with various tools into one tool that does it.
Holistic.
Holistic?
Love that word.
He loves that word.
Did I say that last time?
Yeah, you did.
it's a great word because there's nothing
consistent at least.
Nothing communicates, you know, end to end better than the word holistic.
Although in the cyber world, that's kind of a passe word. Right?
What is going on with the lighting here? The backlight is like really, it's all good. It keeps going in and out. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Whatever. Yeah. So it's a holistic approach to give me a high level kind of view of all my potential vulnerabilities before they become actionable.
Not just vulnerabilities, because vulnerabilities means one specific thing in cyber, but right, all your risks, right? So vulnerabilities are part of your risks. There are other risks that exist in cyber.
Explain the difference between risks and vulnerabilities.
So vulnerabilities is maybe like an area within your you know, existing platforms or software that, you know, might be weak there, and there might be a way to exploit that and get in.
Right.
But there could be things like, for example, and I think we spoke about this in the last interview.
We've done an interview.
Before.
The worst memory ever. Yeah.
Like your physical security, how is that connected to your cyber today? So, you know, we spoke about the cleaning staff last time, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So the cleaning staff is a way into your organization, even though it's not a vulnerability in your software, for example, right?
Right.
But your cyber.
But every vulnerability is a risk.
Sure.
Correct?
Sure. You have to also quantify those as well. Correct.
Interesting. Okay, so tell me about the company a little bit. How many people work at the company now?
11 full-time, 5 part-time, Airport City.
Airport City, super cool place, great vibe there. And you've raised from both private investors and VCs.
Yep.
Can you talk about how much?
A few million dollars.
$2 million, and you're...
And we're raising now our A rounds, a few more million.
A few more than a million. Okay, and you have paying customers, you have pilots, you got things going on. Things are happening.
A lot of stuff.
And big names.
Big names.
It's unbelievable. Oh, and by the way, in terms of advisors of the company, you got some mega big names.
Yeah.
Talk about that, or is that not public information?
No. Dave Johnson is one of our advisors, Blackstone managing partner.
Wow.
We have the former head of PwC cybersecurity practice in the US.
Dude.
Yeah, big names.
Wow, that's incredible. Listen, man, sounds awesome. I could say, you know, I knew you before you were a hotshot. But listen, you know, anything I can do to help in any way, shape, or form. In your case, I'm not BSing. You know.
Nah, this guy's helped us quite a bit. So we have the before and after videos now, so it's pretty good.
Anything I can do to help, you know. By the way, you know, on the marketing front, I don't know. The marketing team that needs some work to amplify. I don't know. I don't even know your challenges, but you know your challenges. If I can help with anything, absolutely let me know. And yeah, dude, keep kicking butt. And I'm looking forward to reading about you in Forbes one day. Thanks, dude.
Thanks, brother.
Cool. Just made it home. That was a long day, but a very, very cool one. Tomorrow, tomorrow's gonna be awesome. See you then.